Hello, my name is Divyanshu Kirti. I study in class 10B in St. Joseph's College, Nainital, and I'll be reciting the poem Television by Roald Dahl. The most important thing we've learned, so far as children are concerned, is never, never, never let them near your television set. Or better still, just don't install the idiotic thing at all. In almost every house we've been, we watch them gaping at the screen. They loll and slop and lounge about and stare until their eyes pop out. Last week, in someone's place, we saw a dozen eyeballs on the floor. They sit and stare and stare and sit until they're hypnotized by it, until they're absolutely drunk with all that shocking, ghastly junk. Oh yes, we know it keeps them still. They don't climb out the windowsill. They never fight or kick or punch. They leave you free to cook the lunch and wash the dishes in the sink. But did you ever stop to think, to wonder just exactly what this does to your beloved top? It rots the sense in the head. It kills imagination dead. It clogs and clutters up the mind. It makes a child so dull and blind he can no longer understand. A fantasy, a fairyland. His brains become as soft as cheese, his powers of thinking rust and freeze, he cannot think, he only sees. All right, you'll cry, all right, you'll say, but if we take the set away, what shall we do to entertain our darling children? Please explain. We'll answer this by asking you, what use the darling ones to do? How use they keep themselves contented before this monster was invented? Have you forgotten? Don't you know? We'll say it very loud and slow. They used to read. They read and read and read and read and then proceed to read some more great Scott Gadzooks. One half their life was reading books. The nursery shelves held books galore. Books cluttered up the nursery floor. And in the bedroom by the bed, more books were waiting to be read. Such wondrous, fine, fantastic tales of dragons, gypsies, queens and whales and treasure isles and distant shores where smugglers roared with muffalos. And pirates wearing purple pants, and sailing ships and elephants, and cannibals crouching round the pot, stirring away at something hot. It smells so good, what can it be? Good gracious, it's Penelope, the younger ones at Beatrix Potter, with Mr. Todd the Dirty Water, and Squirrel Nutting Pigling Band, and Mrs. Tingly Winkle Ant. This how the camel got his hump, and how the monkey lost his rump, and Mr. Toad, and bless my soul, it's Mr. Rat and Mr. Mole. Oh, books, what books they used to know, those children living long ago. So please, oh please, we beg, we pray, go throw your TV set away. And in its place you can install a lovely bookshelf on the wall. Then fill the shelves with lots of books, ignoring all the dirty looks, the screams, the yells, the bites and kicks, and children hitting you with sticks. Fear not, because we promise you that in about a week or two of having nothing else to do, they'll now begin to feel the need of having something to read, and once they start, oh boy, you'll watch the slowly growing joy that fills their hearts till grow so keen, they wonder what they'd ever seen in that ridiculous machine, that nauseating, foul and clean, repulsive television screen. And later, each and every kid will love you more for what you did. Thank you.